and just chat with you for a little minute. I have some hot tea, a cinnamon stick that is basically melted down in this tea, and some honey, which I don't like sweet tea at all. I don't really like cold tea. This is not cold. This is hot, like I mentioned. But I'm doing this because I'm trying to get rid of, you know, the cough and the cold and the whatever, the remnants of COVID and all of that. So I'm still dealing with that. I'm still trying to get rid of it. But if I have a little of this hot tea, so this one is chamomile, honey, and I melted down a cinnamon stick, a real thin one in here. So I'm drinking a little of this. I have a final walkthrough today. I feel so bad because I have to explain to people that I'm coughing because, you know, I got sick, and then they look at me like I'm walking around with the plague. Anyway, I'll deal with that. But it's beautiful today. It's 82 degrees, super sunny, lovely out. So let me go over with you guys what I ate for breakfast this morning. You saw that. So pretty low in points there. Now it is 1:30. So I'm not really hungry yet, but you know what's going to happen? I'm going to get back probably around 3 o'clock, and then I'm going to be starving. And that is when I can make a bad decision. So the good news is I did boil some eggs. So what I think I'm going to do is just kind of chop up, maybe make a little egg salad. So if I have carbs in the morning, then I will generally not have carbs for the rest of the day. Well, I shouldn't say none. I will have, you know, let's say less than 100 for sure. And I try to do less than 50 if I can. So, because like if I have a big bowl of oatmeal, that's a decent amount of carbs, even though it's good carbs, it's a decent amount of it. So I don't want to have carbs for lunch and dinner and then dessert or a snack or something like that. Then it's going to be too many carbs for me, because I told you guys I'm trying to watch my sugars a little bit because I had a little bit of a bad report on that. But yeah, so that is the plan. And then for dinner, what I'm thinking about right now at this moment is chicken. I was going to chop up some chicken and do like burrito bowls minus the rice. That is my plan. But I'm going to be honest with you guys, my chicken is like on the last day that I should be cutting it up. So if it has any weirdness about it, I'm not going to do it because, you know, I don't want food poisoning. Chicken meal prep. I hope you guys can hear me. I'm kind of far away. So I have, these are all two and two chicken breasts, because that's about what we eat, all different sizes. I got these at Costco. So I'm going to start with just a little bit of olive oil. And I do mean a little bit. You can measure this. This is probably 1 teaspoon. And then I'm also going to put a little bit of apple cider vinegar, about a cap, on each one to help tenderize it. Now, you could use lime or lemon juice if you wanted to. You could even use orange juice if you wanted to go for that flavor profile. Just any acid is a good idea. Let me grab my salt. Okay, we're gonna put a little bit of salt in. Not too much, because all of these spices have salt in them. So I don't wanna overdo the salt. Okay, Let's start with this one back here. Let's do our Mexican seasonings. This is the one I'm using. You can use anything, any kind of Mexican seasoning that you like. And you guys can see, hopefully, I am heavily seasoning that. All right, that is one. And I'm gonna add a little bit of garlic because I love garlic and I pretty much put it in everything. By the way, that is garlic powder, not garlic salt. Let's go ahead and throw that on everything while we're here. Okay. Now, on the Mexican one, I'm also going to throw in a little bit of smoked paprika because I like that flavor a lot. Okay. Next, we're going to do a barbecue chicken flavor. This one smells so good. Let's see what this says. Sweet and salty rub, aromatic, bittersweet, and earthy with medium low heat. Sea salt, garlic, brown sugar, onion, California paprika, mustard, cayenne. And it says savory. That smells amazing. I don't count points on my spices at all, so I don't worry about it if there's a little bit of sugar. And then I'm going to do this last one. It's called spicy chicken sprinkle. It smells a little different than this one, so it should give me a little bit different flavor. Whoops. A touch the chicken, so we're not going to use that. Okay, that's got it. Now, the next thing we're going to do, I'm going to use my hands, so if this grosses you out, I'm sorry, but I just kind of get this all coated, and then I am going to cook all of these tonight because I want to have these through the week. We want to do a lot with chicken this week. Kevin is trying to get back on plan with me. So it's really important to have it done. And we both have a lot going on this week, so I don't want to worry about cooking it. And this reheats really well. All right, I'm going to come around the other side. And then you're just gonna bake this in a casserole dish in the foil pack at 350 for about 30 minutes. I don't overcook it. It's never dry though. It is really, really good, always. Okay, I'm gonna wash my hands and then we'll get this in the oven. Okay, we had a change of pace here. We decided to do two and put one in the freezer and mark what it is and the date. So we're gonna do two of them tonight. Okay, now it's going in the oven.